Welcome to the E Academy. Today's episode will be the first in a series dedicated to slimline motion detectors. Slimline includes as many as 10 new devices. They all have the same enclosure, which makes it difficult for an intruder to recognize a particular detector model used in the system. All detectors installed in the premises look identical. Now I will briefly discuss the basic differences between them. The first five of them come equipped with a passive infrared sensor. The next five are dual-tech models, which, in addition to the PIR sensor, also have a built-in microwave sensor. The detectors with the LUNA designation in their name have a set of LEDs for implementation of the lighting feature. They also offer the option of programming two sensitive thresholds and remote switching between them. This is done by connecting the detector SENS terminal to the common ground. Devices that have the PET designation in their name are immune to the movement of small pets. Models designated as Pro have the interactive IR anti-masking function, so they can report attempts to cover up, tape up, or spray paint the lens. The Slim PIR Pro and Slim Dual Pro detectors meet requirements of the EN 50131 standard for Grade 3, while all other models of the Slimline family meet the requirements for Grade 2. For more information on each model and more detailed description of their functions, please check the materials available below the video. Additionally, individual functions and how to configure detectors will be discussed in the next episodes about the Slimline series. Today, I will focus on several solutions that have been used in the Slimline devices, which are designed to speed up and streamline the installer's work. The first of them is the practical mechanism for opening and closing of the detector enclosure. All you need to get inside the enclosure is a flat blade screwdriver. Use it to rotate the lock located on the bottom of enclosure by approximately 90 degrees in the direction marked by the arrows. The enclosure cover will then snap open slightly. Now you can easily remove it to gain access to the electronic components inside. Closing of the enclosure is even easier because no tools are needed to do it. Just place the cover back and gently press the bottom part. A characteristic click is heard. That's it, the enclosure has been closed. You do not need to secure the enclosure of slimline detectors with additional screws or bolts, which can be easily dropped and lost. This is important during installation when you have to, for example, stand on a ladder. Each detector has a tamper switch that reacts to opening of the closure, so there is no way to get inside the detector imperceptibly. Additionally, in detectors containing the LUNA and PRO designations in their name, a tamper switch is also used that reacts to removal of the detector from mounting. Now, as for mounting the devices, the slimline detectors can be screwed directly to a flat surface or attached at an angle of 45 degrees, which is possible because of a properly profiled enclosure. If it turns out that it will be best to mount the detector at a different angle in the given location or tilt it vertically, you can use the special bracket D mount for this purpose. By using it, you can adjust the detector tilt angle horizontally within 90 degrees, as well as tilt the detector about 15 degrees up or 20 degrees down in the vertical plane. An undisputable advantage of the bracket D holder, which contributes to the aesthetically pleasing appearance as well as the security of the installation, is that the detector leading wire can be passed through it and thus concealed in its interior. An important note, the bracket D holder is delivered with Slim PIR LUNA and Slim Dual LUNA detectors. It is also included in the delivery set with the Slim PIR Pro and Slim Dual Pro models. However, in their case, the bracket has an additional tamper switch, which serves as a protection against removal of the device with its bracket from the mounting. This solution is necessary so that the Pro detectors, when mounted on the bracket, can meet the EN 50131 requirements for Grade 3. For the other detector models, the brackets can be purchased separately. Another useful feature that can speed up and improve convenience of the installation process is the application of built-in end-of-line resistors in slimline detectors. All devices come equipped with 1.1 kilo-ohms resistors, which enables them to be connected to SATEL alarm control panels in 2EOL-NC configuration. The LUNA and PRO versions of the detectors, because of the use of two additional pairs of resistors, are also ready to work with other types of alarm control panels. Since I have already mentioned connecting the detectors, it is worth noting that the LUNA and PRO versions come with a plug-in terminal block. Thus, when connecting the wires to screw terminals, you can put the PC board aside and thus reduce the risk of accidentally damaging it, or, for example, touching and soiling the pyro element. The plug-in terminal block made it possible to quickly and easily replace the detector electronics without having to disconnect the wires from screw terminals. As you can see, electronics of PIR detector was replaced with that of DualTech detector in just a few seconds. Another solution intended to facilitate the installer's work is the option of changing the detector working parameters by using the OPT1 key fob, which is available in Luna and Pro models. It allows you to easily change the settings, including sensor sensitivity, operating mode, LED indicator light color, and LED lighting pattern, without having to open the detector enclosure each time. That's all for today. As I mentioned before, individual functions and configuration of the slimline detectors will be discussed in the next episodes. Thank you, and until our next meeting at the eAcademy, see you then!